The coronavirus pandemic has caused a global upset. Shortage of medical equipment worsened the case. An equipment of obvious importance is the medical ventilator, a critical equipment for patients who have critical cases, requiring intensive care. Teams all over the world rushed to provide solutions to the global medical shortage, but many DIY, rapid deployable ventilators produced to fill up the global shortage, have not been really employed. A quick search on the internet would reveal that many DIY, cheap, open source designs have been made available, but medical experts did not accept these equipments to use alongside traditional ventilators, due to various fears. So, why did we not employ DIY ventilators in the fight against COVID-19? Well, it turns out that the ventilator is a really complex machine. A medical ventilator is an equipment used for advanced respiratory therapy, ART. ART is used for patients who have difficulty breathing or have paralyzed lungs. First of all, we need to understand what ventilators are, and how they work. They are powerful enough for saving lives when used appropriately, and equally powerful enough for damaging lives when used inappropriately. Therefore, this is one of the most challenging of all therapies, not because the therapy on its own is so complex, but because of the complexity of the ventilator machine itself. Therefore, the effectiveness of the therapy is highly dependent of the specialist knowledge of the situation. The ventilator mixes an adjustable amount of medical-grade oxygen with medical-grade air or medical-grade nitrogen with adjustable flow rates and sensors for feedback. So they consist of a network of complicated systems and valves with precise adjustable systems. But to explain the working principle, we will just oversimplify them. Just think of it as a jet engine. The principle is simple, but a jet engine is one of the most complex machines you can find. So how do ventilators work? Considering an oxygen tank connected to a pipe that is connected to a balloon, and another pipe connected from a point on the first pipe. Consider the two hands in the picture as A and B, which act as valves. When A opens and B is closed, the balloon inflates. When A closes and B opens simultaneously, the balloon deflates as the gas goes to the subject. The valves are called inspiratory and expiratory valves, and this is basically how the ventilator works. Research and engineering teams around the world picked up the challenge. A dozen prototypes were developed by teams working on Slack channels, Facebook pages, and GitHub repositories. Colin Keough, an expert in 3D printing with his team in Dublin, developed a prototype that automates ambulance breathing bags with variable pressure modes for use as a last line of defense. The Oxvent Group, a group of Oxford University and King's College students, have also developed a prototype using low-cost materials. Also, a research team at MIT known as MIT Event have also developed a low-cost portable ventilator by creating a mechanical device that squeezes ambu bags. Jacobs School of Engineering UC San Diego have also prototyped a similar design making use of ambu bags. There are so many others, including Rubicum, a Polish company which successfully built a prototype that runs on compressed air. Technically, you can build cheaper DIY ventilators using ambu bags. But recall I said traditional ventilators are complex machines with complex controls tailored to suit each patient's need. This cannot be easily done in DIY. Another issue with the open source and DIY ventilators is reliability. A ventilator could save lives, but it could equally kill. It is also a life-critical ICU equipment, which must be built to a high degree of accuracy and specialization so as not to cause complications. This is why medical experts advised against these ventilators, suggesting that teams focus more on masks and protective equipment, since ventilators are just a part of the whole equation. For example, Andrea Ippoito, a lecturer of engineering management at Cornell University, said, You do not want DIY ventilators out there if they do not need to be, but if we reach the point where hundreds or thousands or millions of people are dying because there are not enough ventilators, then DIY ones are the backup. DIY ventilators, especially ambu bag ventilators, do not offer the complexity and precision of the traditional ventilators. So it's best to leave them to the production companies to ramp up their production. DIY teams have also shifted their attention to the production of face masks and other protective gear. Thanks for watching this episode of Unravel. Please do like, share and subscribe to my channel to see more videos as this. See you next time.